Sifa tena. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Encourage me with a bigger amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. So, karibuni kanisani mara tena. We are blessed to be here. Na ni baraka kubwa sana ambayo Mwenyezi Mungu ametubariki siku ya leo kukua katika nyumba yake. Hallelujah. Today I want to speak about something very important. And this is maybe for those who write. I want to speak about understanding the biblical ordinances. Kuelewa ama jinsi ya kuelewa maagizo ama kanuni za kibiblia. Kanuni za kibiblia, ordinances. Kuna yale mambo ambayo ni muhimu kuweza kuyaelewa. Niposa tunapoongea kuhusu imani yetu kama wa Kristo, ni vizuri kuweza kujua ni nini hicho ambacho tunaamini, na kile tunachoamini ni vizuri pia kujua kama kiko sawa ama hakiko sawa. But in this time I'm talking about the biblical ordinances. And maybe for those who write, ordinance and ordinance, it's a religious ritual whose intent or purpose it is to demonstrate an adherent faith. It's a religious ritual. So, ni ibada ama ni mila ya kikristo ambayo kusudi lako ni kudhihirisha imani ya anayeamini. Praise the name of Jesus. That is an ordinance. Ordinance, of course, ni agizo ama kanuni. So, kanuni ambayo ni ya kiroho. Not a religious. It's a ritual ni mila ama ibada. And so as we continue understanding our theme for this year of laying the right foundations, it is very important, and it's also good that we understand the two ordinances of our Christian faith. Now, katika kwa Kristo, kuna ordinance mbili, hizo agizo ama kanuni mbili, ambazo ni muhimu sana na Yesu Kristo mwenyewe aliagiza ya kwamba kila muumini aweze kuzifanya. Na ningependa uweke makini sana niposa uweze kusikiza. Of course, for today I'll speak about one. Mungu akitupea nafasi wakati mwingine, tuongee kuhusu hiyo nyingine. And many Christians today, they avoid them. Now, these two ordinances, let me just mention them. Moja ni the Lord's table, ama meza ya Bwana, na ingine ni baptism. Hizi mbili ziko na mafunzo ambayo, nikubarishe niseme pale nje kuna mafunzo potovu, na kuna mengine inakaa kukanganya, and of course kuna mafunzo mazuri, ambao kwa neema ya Mwenyezi Mungu nataka kuamini jinsi Roho Mtakatifu atakavyoniwezesha nitakuletea hayo iliyo ya kibiblia. That is why I spoke about, actually sikusema heading yangu ni understanding ordinances. I'm speaking about biblical ordinances. Kwa hivyo ni za kibiblia. Tunapata agizo ama maagizo haya kanuni hizi katika Biblia. And so I'm saying that many Christians avoid this ordinances due to the foundations which were laid. Watu wengi nasema mimi kubatizwa, nafikiri ni batizwa nikiwa mtoto. Kama ni meza ya Bwana, mimi nafikiri ni kanisani kwetu tu ama mahali ambapo nilibatizwa. Hapo ndipo peke yake ninajua, niliambiwa, ninaweza kukula meza ya Bwana ama kubatizwa. All these you realize, they are as a result of foundations, misingi. Mahali ambapo kila mmoja ambapo aliweza kulelewa ama to be brought up. But I want to believe that by the grace of God, the Holy Spirit will help us to understand. Now, I've said the two ordinances, one of them is the Holy Communion, na ya pili ni the baptism. And today, I want to speak about the Holy Communion, ama meza ya Bwana. Now, the Holy Communion, it is also called the Lord's Table or the Lord's Supper. Bwana sikiwe sana. Praise the name of the Lord. It is also called the Lord's Table or the Lord's Supper. Holy Communion, ushirika mtakatifu, ambao pia unaitwa meza ya Bwana. ama pia unaitwa ile karamu ya mwisho yake Mwenyezi Mungu. And nimesema from definition, it is a religious ritual. Ni mila ama ibada ya kiroho ambayo inadhihirisha anayeamini. It demonstrates the faith of the adherent or someone's faith. Inadhihirisha imani ya mtu fulani. Na nikasema, let me just say a ritual. Maybe I interpret for us or I define the ritual for us. A ritual is a religious ceremony consisting of a series of actions performed according to a prescribed manner. Ritual. It's a religious ceremony. Ni ibada ama sherehe ya ki Kristo ama ya kidini ambayo inahusisha mambo kadha wa kadha ambayo inafanywa kwa njia iliyo na mpangilio. So rituals, you don't just perform a ritual vyovyote vile. You don't just perform a ritual. Kuna rituals mingi sana. Ukienda mlima Kenya, wakati wale wazee wanaomba kwa ule mlima, unaitamba ni mlima Kenya ama ni Kirinyaga, wale wazee ambao wanakuomba wamevaa nguo za brown, si mnawajua? Ama mmeona kwa TV. Ama ukienda Meru, kuna wazee fulani hapo wanajulikana sana, nikiuliza mtajua. Ukienda Kisii ama mahali pengine, hao wazee wanapoenda kwa zile miti ama mahali fulani, what they do is rituals they offer ama they do. Na hawafanyangi tu hivyo, kuna heshima zake. Actually unaweza enda pale na mdomo na you know maneno yako mengi mahali wazee wana perform ritual, wewe ni kijana uanze kusema nini, ufike pale wakwambie what are you telling us. Na uitisho nini? Thank you. Unanyamaza hapa aje kama mjini. Thank you. Uitisho buzi. Na wazee wewe unakuwa umeharibu, unataka kuharibu nini hii ibada? Kwa kuitisha mbuzi. Na sio kabuzi, buzi ambaye hako na afya. Kwa sababu umekuja kwa ribu mira. So you are saying, it's something performed according to a prescribed order. And you realize, even in the order ambayo tunafanya, na tutafanya hata siku ya leo ya meza ya Bwana, it is something that iko na heshima yake. And I want to believe that by the grace of God, you'll be able to understand this. Therefore, we are doing it, the Lord's table, ama the Holy Communion, we do it in accordance to our faith in Jesus. Sasa, Yesu ndiye mwanzilishi wa hii, tutaona hivyo, na ni vizuri kujua kwamba tunapoifanya, tunaifanya in accordance, tukiwa tunafuatilia imani ya Yesu Kristo. Another thing we need to understand is that we do it in obedience to Jesus himself. Tunafanya meza ya Bwana ama kula karamu ya kujikumbusha ile hali ya kula karamu ya mwisho ya Bwana Yesu katika hali ya kuweza kutii in obedience to Jesus himself who told us to do it more often. Yesu alituambia kwamba mara mingi mnapokutana fanyeni hivi kwa ajili ya kukumbusho wangu. Praise the name of Jesus. So many people believe so much, you know, kuna watu wengi sana wanaamini vitu mingi sana kuhusu hii meza ya Bwana. But I want to believe, you will believe and you will know it the biblical way. Not the way it has been put somewhere that you could have really fanywa. Unajua kuna watu wanaingiaka mahali wanakuta kitu inafanywa, and mara mingi they don't want to know why is this happening. Unakuta wazee wamekaa kando mahali, kuna mbuzi wamechinja ama nini, wameketi pale, wanakula ile mbuzi ama nini, na wewe pia unaingia pale, unaanza kukula, na ujui mbona wanakula, hila wanakula, ama lile tendo ambalo wanafanya mahali pale. It is good to know what is happening, and why is this thing being done, even before you involve yourself into it. Praise the name of Jesus. So the question is, what and why is it called the Holy Communion? Kuna maswali mbili hapa. Ni nini ama kwa nini hii tunaongelelea kuhusu leo ordinance ya meza ya Bwana? Kwa nini inaitwa Holy Communion? It is a Christian ritual. Ni ibada ya Wakristo. Com- commemorate, inakumbuka ama inatukumbusha Jesus' last supper or the meal with the disciples. Inatukumbusha, ni ukumbusho wa meza ama karamu ya mwisho, chakula cha mwisho ambacho Yesu Kristo alikula pamoja na wanafunzi wake. And here, wakati alikuwa pamoja na wanafunzi wake, I'm going to show you a few scriptures. He gave bread. Alipatia, alichukua mkate, akawapatia wale wanafunzi wake na akasema, "This is my body. Huu ni mwili wangu." And also, akachukua divai na akasema, "Hii ni damu yangu." Bwana asifiwe sana. So that is what we call the Lord's or the Holy Communion. And the reason why we also call it the Holy Communion, it was Jesus himself who instituted it. Ni Yesu mwenyewe ambaye alianzisha. So it is also an institution. Let's look at Matthew chapter 26 and from verse 26 in a sermon. "Now as they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it. Then he broke it in pieces and gave it to the disciples, saying, 'Take this and eat it, for this is my body.'" And in verse 27, "And he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. He gave it to them and said, 'Each of you drink from it.'" Verse 28, "For this is my blood, which confirms the covenant between God and his people." Now, listen to this. Hii ni kali. Hii mstari ni kali. Ya kwamba unapo inyo, isa kimwili na damu ya Yesu Kristo katika ile hali ya ukumbusho, inadhihirisha wakati Yesu wako pale na wanafunzi wake anawaambia, "Hii ambayo tunafanya hapa inadhihirisha agano ambalo Mungu ameweka na watu wake. It is poured out as a sacrifice to forgive the sins of many." Verse 21, "Mark my words. I will not drink wine again until the day I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." So what I'm saying is this. It was Jesus mwenyewe. So kile ambacho tunafanya hapa, it is obeying and following Jesus. Kuna neno lingine ambayo the Lord's Table pia inaitwa ambayo si kusema pale nyuma. It is also called the breaking of bread. It is called the breaking of bread. You can check Acts chapter 2 maybe. You can check Acts chapter 2 and verse 42. Maybe in a sema hivi. "That all the believers devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship and to sharing in meals, including the Lord's Supper and to prayer." So it was bringing the church together. It was also done in fellowship. Na ndiyo tunaona ya kwamba kuna msali ambao tutasoma hapo awali, hapo tukisonga ya kwamba ni vizuri wakati tunashiriki tunangojea na mmoja kwa mwingine, ndiyo tunapoila tunaikula katika hali ya umoja, ile hali ya ushirika. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, the nature and the meaning of the Lord's Table, umuhimu wa meza, kuna mambo kadha wa kadha ambayo ni vizuri tuweze kuielewa na kuijua tunapoongea kuhusu meza ya Bwana. Praise the name of Jesus. And I spoke of this as an ordinance. Ni ile ni funzo ama ni agizo ambalo ni vizuri kama wa Kristo tuweze kulifanya, kudhihirisha imani yetu katika Kristo Yesu. Now, let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 11 ambao ni mstari ama mistari ambayo tunaisoma mara mingi. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 from verse 23, Biblia inasema ya kwamba, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes." Verse 27. "Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. A man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself. That is why many among you are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if we judged ourselves, we would not come under judgment. When we are judged by the Lord, we are being disciplined so that we will not be condemned with the world." Verse 33, "So then, my brothers, when you come together to eat, wait for each other. If anyone is hungry, he should eat at home, so that when you meet together, it may not result in judgment. And when I come, I will give you further directions." This is Paul. Paul and Asamiya Komba, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you." This, in an Yeleza ya Komba, kile ambacho, huyu mtumishi wa Mungu Paulo anazungumza hapa, si maneno yake mwenyewe. He says, "I am passing to you that which I also received from the Lord." Na kuna maneno ambayo nataka tuweze kujua hapa. Kuna there's somebody called Sam Storms, ambaye ameandika maneno kadha wa kadha, ambayo katikati ya kila ambacho nimeweza kutayarisha, nimeomba a few knowledge or wisdom from him. And one of the things nataka tuweze kuelewa kanisa, ni ya kwamba, nature na meaning ya mwili wa Kristo ama meza ya Bwana, jambo moja ni ya kwamba, it brings us to remembrance of the work of Jesus Christ. Bwana Yesu wapewe sifa. Inatukumbusha, inatuleta karibu, niposa tuweze kukumbuka kazi ya Kristo Yesu. Na let me tell you church, sio vibaya kukumbuka mtu ambaye amefanya kitu kizuri ndani ya maisha yako. It is not. Actually, if someone does something to you, it is good to remember them and once in a while call them, appreciate them. Hata kama huto wakumbusha kile walifanya, ni vizuri kukua unawakumbuka more often. And when you remember them, call them, pray for them, be there for them. Sometimes they are in need of you. Be there for them. There are some sacrifices walifanya kwa sababu yako. It is also good for you to be there for them. Now, if you look at what Jesus did on the cross many, many years, it is good to remember him. And that is why we remember God and Christ Jesus and worship him and pray to him every morning. But also, in a better way, it is good to remember him by coming and sharing the Lord's table. Verse 25, actually, to sit talk about 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Verse 25, in Asamiya Komba, "In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, 'This is the cup, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink, in remembrance of me.'" One is a superior son. Many times when we think of people who have died in our lives, actually, mara mingi tunapenda kukumbuka ni nini ambacho walisema, wish, ama ni nini ambacho walifanya. Praise the name of Jesus. We want to remember what is it that they did, ni nini ambacho walisema, ni nini ambacho walitufanyia. You know, leo tukianza kukumbuka in our nation, wale marais ambao tumekuwa na wao, rais wa kwanza na pia wa pili wa taifa letu la Kenya, mara mingi hatutaki kuwakumbuka kwa vituko walizofanya ama mambo mabaya waliofanya. Tunawakumbuka kwa sababu ya zile vitu nzuri ambao walifanya. So when we talk about the Holy Communion, we remember Jesus and the work that he did for us. Now, number two, it is commanded of us to do this. Verse 25 ambayo nimesoma bini nasema ya kwamba do this. Now the word do, it is a command. It's an instruction.
Hallelujah.
It's an instruction. So we are told to. And let me tell you, there is nothing as good as to walk in obedience, church. Hakuna kitu kizuri kama kutii neno, especially the word of God. We can disregard any other person. We can disobey any other person because labda kenyo natopia, hakiyadamani na imani yetu. But we cannot avoid, listen to this, we cannot avoid, ama we cannot dare disobey God or the word of God. Number three is that the use, we also need to remember the use of the what we call the tangible elements. Elements is what we use to remember the Lord's table. Ama to remember the Ibada, ama kalamu kwa Yesu Kristo, alikuwa nayo ya mwisho. Elements is basically the cup of juice, maybe. Some will use wine, some will use the juice, or the body. Some will use blood, you know, that you call as sacraments. But those are the word to use is not very much important, but to understand the impact yake. Now, the bread and the cup are this, you know, they stir our minds and hearts. You know, vile ambavyo tunachukua, actually as we shall be doing that, ukiangalia kikombe unachochukua, na kilicho ndani, na mkate ambao unachukua, it should stir your mind and your heart to think about Jesus and why he had to die on the cross for you and for me and for the church and for the whole world. Praise the name of Jesus. Actually, the act of eating the Lord's table reminds us that we spiritually depend on Jesus. Every time tunapokuja kula meza ya Bwana, tunakumbuka ya kwamba kiroho inafaa kutukumbusha, we depend on Jesus. Tegemeo letu tunamtegemea Yesu. And the benefits of his life, death and resurrection. Tunapokumbuka hali ya Yesu, kuna benefits ambazo anaacha wakati alituambia tufanye hivyo kila wakati tunapokutana. Number one is the benefit of his life. Number two is the benefit of his death. And number two, it is the benefit of his resurrection. Now, kuna mtu anaweza uliza benefit ya death ni nini? Because maybe you've ever lost somebody and you felt it was heavy. I've ever lost somebody and it was very heavy. Very, very heavy. But you see now, man is not like Jesus. The good thing about Jesus is he died and 3 days later he arose from the dead. He conquered death. He is alive today. Praise the name of Jesus. We are not talking of somebody who died. Na akaenda aliyedaga. Alienda na akarudi. Praise the name of Jesus. One of the things that we need to know is this. Physical food has its benefits. And so it is spiritual food. So the benefits of the body and the blood of Jesus, they flourish our spiritual life. Every time, because I want us to understand, and if we don't understand even after this, you can ask me. If we understand or take this service or these elements with the right understanding and with the right focus, what they do is they flourish our spiritual life. Maisha yetu ya kiroho. Tunavyo mwelewa huyu Mungu. Tunavyo mbeba. You know, the way we behave, the way we view Jesus Christ, it refreshes our spiritual lives. Number four, it is a personal remembrance. It is a personal remembrance. Number 25, in the same way, after supper, he took the cup saying, this is the new cup in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. So it is a personal remembrance. You are remembering Jesus. Actually, we are not remembering the disciples of Jesus. Tunapoida meza ya Bwana. But it's a personal remembrance. A personal remembrance of Jesus Christ. Our personal Savior. And I thank God for those people that are testifying and they are like, Jesus is my personal savior. That's a powerful one. Because he saved you as a person. He did not save you as a mob. Hata mkienda mahali mkutu ya kwamba umeokoka watu 200, 500, watu 12. Haa, siya kwamba ni nini wote, it's a personal thing. And that is why, wakati unafanya that sinner's prayer, that confession prayer, you are doing it alone and it's coming from your heart. Also your mouth. Praise the name of Jesus. So it's a personal remembrance of Jesus. Also, in the Lord's table, there is confession. Kuna hali ya kutubu. It is good to know that and declare that Christ Jesus gave his body and blood for us. He died for us. So for one to remember or partake the communion, the Lord's communion, we need to have confessed Jesus in our lives. Actually, this is one of the requirements. You must have confessed Jesus Christ in your heart. And that is why Jesus had time only with his disciples. He had time with them. He knew their faith. He knew that these people are believers and they believed in me. So one must be able to personally and consciously confess that the bread and the cup symbolize the body and blood of Jesus, which was sacrificed for sinners. Now, the purpose of Jesus upon the cross, mwili wake, na damu yake, the suffering that he went through, it was to forgive sins. And therefore, we are living and we have lived in the past a life of sin before we confess Christ. And so for you to be able to have access or to qualify to share in the Lord's table, ni vizuri uweze kumepatia maisha yako Yesu. And personally, you are able to and consciously confess Christ. Number seven, this is very key. Number six, sorry. We must proclaim the Lord's still death till he comes. Tunapo yule meza ya Bwana, tunajaribu kuonyesha ulimwengu, tunatangaza kwa ulimwengu ya kwamba, namba tunatangaza kifo cha Yesu Kristo, mpaka verse, that is verse 6. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Until he comes. So meaning, it is an ordinance that looks into the future. There is hope. We still, as we celebrate it, tunapoketi hivi tunakuwa tunajua kwamba Yesu one day, hallelujah. This is great, this is powerful. One day, he will come for the church. One day, maybe we will have another table to celebrate the second coming of Jesus. And this one, every one of us will long for it. And the good way of longing for the second coming of Jesus, because he will come, and he's coming for the clean church, he's coming for those people who have given their lives to him. You must have had a relationship with him. Number seven. This one is powerful and it's good. He was when you misquote, na ukosa kuelewa Mungu atusaidie kuweza kuelewa. It must be taken in a worthy manner. Actually, many people don't take it. Yet, they are believers. Kuna watu wengi sana, wanakosa kuchukua meza ya Bwana kwa sababu labda, hatukuongea vizuri na mke wangu asubuhi, ama nilikeresha mtoto asubuhi, ama kuna vile mambo haiendi vizuri kwangu, you know, the way, you know, all those things, but I want to believe that God is going to help us to understand it. Even believers, we find ourselves in the same. Now, verse 27. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. What does it mean taking the Lord's table in an unworthy manner? Jia ambayo haistahili. This would mean, one, without regard to its true worth. Unapo ila meza ya Bwana, na hauelewi umuhimu wake, haujui, you know, actually tuseme, haujui umuhimu wake, then that is taking it in an unworthy manner.
Another area is that if you take it, or if you come with self, you know, ile hali ya kujua kusema ya kwamba mimi si ni mtu wa kanisa, si nimelelewa kwa jamii ya Kristo, so I qualify. In other words, unakuja kuila with light hearted. You hauna wewe unaona tu ni acha Yesu na kuranga meza ya Bwana hivi imani. So si ibada hii haraka tumalize tukunywe kama juice ni nyumbani. That is unworthy manner. It is not a good way of waiting for this. Another way also, meaning of maybe taking it in an unworthy manner could be not taking or not giving a careful thought to what the element signify. You are not taking a careful thought into what that bread will signify, into that what cup, with whatever is inside will signify. They signify, they are not the real thing. Now, there are some people who will say, wakati nakula ile mkate na ile kikombe tunachokunywa ni reality. It is the real body and the real blood. Not necessarily. We may not have time to get deeper into that. But the point is this, they signify. And so tunapozichukua ni vizuri kukua na uelewa ya kwamba this is about what Jesus did. A very good example. Wakati Yesu wako pale na wanafunzi wake anawaambia hii ni mwili wangu na hii ni damu yangu. Tuliona ama maybe for those who have watched the movie. Kuna mahali ambapo Yesu alijikata akawaambia sasa hii mwili wangu kuleni na akawakatakatia tunyama tudogo. Unajua ukienda butchery na unanunua kanyama kabia unawaambia kata kidogo kidogo. No? Hakuna mahali Yesu aliwaambia sasa kuleni hii ama akatoa damu alafu akaisifu kwa kikombe mahali akasema hii ni damu yangu. Hakuna mahali aliyofanya hivyo. So it is signifying. Praise the name of Jesus. It is signifying. So it could also, in another manner, could also mean disregarding others in the body of Christ. Taking it in another manner. Disregarding others in the body of Christ. Look at verse 20. Verse 20 of the same scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Verse 20 nasema hivi. When you come together, it is not the Lord's Supper you eat. For as you eat, each of you goes ahead without waiting for anybody else. One remains hungry, another gets drunk. Do you have homes to eat and drink it? Or do you despise the church of God and humiliate those who have nothing? What shall I say? Shall I praise you for this certainly? No. So when you come together, and you don't regard others, you are the better than others, in the place now to know ile meza ya Bwana. And you tukasema ya kwamba ni vizuri tungojeane because it is also showing the aspect of fellowship and oneness and unity. Praise the name of Jesus. Another area also where it can be taken in an unworthy manner, it is when we disregard of what the element represents. Tunapokuja na tuseme ya kwamba nitakula ndio lakini hiyo sio mwili wa Kristo. Nitakula ndio lakini hiyo sio damu ya Yesu. That is not doing it in the right manner. It is not worthy for you to take it like that. Number 8, the Lord's Supper is a sacred ordinance. The Lord's Supper is a sacred ordinance. Ni sadaka ama ni ibada ambayo ni teule. Ni ibada ambayo ni takatifu. And number 9, also, we need to examine ourselves as we partake of the Lord's table. We need to test our motives and our attitudes. This is that we take, it means that we need to take it with the right understanding and with the right motive of what the elements represent. And I'm keeping repeating this, the apostle with you, Akomba. This is a representation, this is a remembrance of what Jesus meant, of what Jesus intended these ordinances or these elements to mean. The last one is, if we don't do all of these things that we have spoken about and lead
will lead to a divine discipline. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 29 and to 34. Tulikuwa tumeisoma. Verse 29 inasema namna gani. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body, the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself. That is why among you many are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if we judge ourselves, we will not come under judgment. If we judge ourselves, in other words, if we examine ourselves, we will not be judged. Ni lazima tuweze kujichunguza vizuri. Ni neno yetu. Now, the intention yetu kukuja kula meza ya Bwana iko namna gani. And if we realize that we have been doing it in the wrong manner, it is the high time for us to go before God and tell God, this is, I have not understood it before. I've just been taking it, you know, not right. Intention yangu ijakuwa nzuri. So, this, what I'm saying is this, that it does not mean that because you did something wrong na mtu, ama mtu sikiza na mtu, you cannot partake of the Lord's Supper. Many other times with the enemy, then adui akijua iko ndivyo unajua, atakuwa na make sure kwamba every time kuna nafasi ya kula meza ya Bwana mnakosana. Ndio usipate the real thing. Atakuwa na make sure hivyo. The devil is a liar, he's a schemer, he's very clever, by the way. Don't underestimate the power that the enemy has. But the good thing is that his power cannot be compared with the power of our God. Praise the name of Jesus. So the Bible says lastly, if anyone is hungry, he should eat at home, so that when we be together in our, it may not result in judgment. Then Paul says, when I come, I'll give you more instructions. I'll tell you. So one of the things we need to do is this, church. It is to walk in obedience to the word. It is to walk in obedience to the word of God. We want to have that size right now. And before we go there, one of the requirements, as I say, it is to have received Christ as Lord God and Savior in my life. Maybe you're there and you've not given your life to Jesus, and you want to receive the blessings thereof in the partaking of this Lord's table. Everyone who is a believer, regardless of the denomination, you qualify to share the Lord's table together with us. Now, I've not shared the benefits, the implications, there are so much, but there are things that do happen upon taking the Holy Communion. You can imagine Jesus himself is telling you, take this, is for me. This represents my body. This represents my blood. And we speak about the power in the blood. Now, when we speak about the power in the blood, the power can be able to heal. Hallelujah. The power can be able to restore. The power can be able to save. The power can be able to release. The power can be able to transform. Hallelujah. The power can be able to make things that are crooked work right. The power can be able to change destinies. The power can be able to transform the life that has been crooked into the way you want it to be. The power. A life that has been a life of struggle, the power is able to do it. The power of Jesus, that is. So I want us to bow down our hands. I want us to bow down our hands before the Lord. And if you're there, you're not sick, I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Maybe you go pale na hujaokoka. Na ungependa kupeana maisha yako kwa Yesu. Ungependa uweze kurudia ombi hili. Na utaweza kuokoka. Na utaweza kushiriki pamoja. Sema Bwana Yesu, mimi ni mwenye dhambi. Nimejitawala mwenyewe siku mingi. Kutoka siku ya leo, ninatubu dhambi zote. Ninatubu makosa yangu. Kutoka sasa, ninaachana na shetani na kazi zake zote. Ninaamua kukufuata. Roho Mtakatifu, nisaidie, nijaze, nitengeneze, nikae jinsi upendavyo. Kutoka sasa, nimekiri ya kwamba Yesu ni Bwana na nimeokoka. Katika jina la Yesu. Amen. Baba, nakushukuru kwa sababu ya mmoja ambaye amefanya ombi hili. Ninakushukuru Bwana kwa sababu ya maisha yake. Ninakushukuru Bwana kwa sababu umefanya maisha yake kuwa mapya. Neno lako linasema ya kwamba mmoja anapokuja kwa Kristo maisha ya kale yanapita mama sasa yanakuwa mapya. Mungu wa amani ukatengeneze hali ya maisha yake kuwa mapya. Na ukamtengenezee njia panapokaa kana kwamba hapana njia. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you praise and we give you honor. May you minister to them and may your grace be sufficient upon their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you praise and we give you honor. In Jesus' name we pray and we give thanks.